إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونتوب إليه ونصلي ونسلم على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وبارك وسلم تسليما كثيرا. All praise due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We praise him and we seek the help from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Whomever Allah guide, no one misguide him, and whomever misguide, no one will guide him. I bear witness and I believe there is no worthy to be worshipped except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Muhammad is a last and final messenger. We thanks Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to gather us here to share some beneficial knowledge, to share something amazing, important, can change our life, can bring happiness for our life in dunya and akhirah. Today, inshallah, by the will of Allah, we're going to talk about the attribute and the characteristic of the people of heaven, the people of paradise, the people of Al-Jannah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us Al-Jannah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us Al-Jannah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us with the permanent mercy. Jannatin arduha as-samawati wal-ardu u'iddat lil-muttaqin. Paradise, heaven, the width like the heaven and the earth, prepared to whom have a taqwa, to whom have a fearness and awareness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Today, by the will of Allah, we're going to talk about the attribute and the characteristic of the people of Al-Jannah. The attribute number 23. What this attribute? As-sidq. 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 What is mean as-sidq? As-sidq mean the truth, to be truthful. The truth and to be truthful, it's one of the very, very important attribute and character to achieve Al-Jannah, to get the permanent blessing from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. الصدق. الصدق مع الله. الصدق مع الناس. الصدق حقيقة. الصدق رحمة. الصدق خير وبركة. الصدق one of the very, very, very important character. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made the second level after the messenger and prophet, the prophecy level. Straight away, what is the second level? As-siddiqeen. فَأُولَٰئِكَ مَعَ الَّذِينَ أَنْعَمَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِمْ مِنَ النَّبِيِّينَ من النبيين والصديقين والشهداء والصالحين وحسن أولئك رفيقا. فأولئك مع الذين أنعم الله عليهم. Those will be with the one Allah bless them. Bless them. Allah سبحانه وتعالى grant them blessing. Who they are? النبيين, the messengers and the prophet. والصديقين, the truthful one. والشهداء, the martyrs, الشهداء, الشهيد. والصالحين, the righteousness, righteousness, the righteous people. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put the level of الصديقين higher than الشهداء, higher than الصالحين, higher than pious people. الصديقين, الصدق, one of the very important character, very important character and attribute to have it in order to achieve Al-Jannah. Let's inshallah watch this small clip. Inshallah, then we go through the lecture. What an amazing ayah from the verses of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَالَّذِي جَاءَ بِالصِّدْقِ وَصَدَّقَ بِهِ أُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْمُتَّقُونَ. والذي جاء the one he bring and come with truth, come with the الصدق والذي جاء بالصدق وصدق به, and he believe in the truthness, he believe in the truth. Islam is a truth, الجنة is a truth, جهنم is a truth, حق truth, يوم القيامة is a truth, is a حق. The one he come with the belief of the truth, believing in the truth, and he was a truthful person. وصدق به أولئك هم المتقون. Those they are the one they have a taqwa, the one they have the awareness and fearness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. لهم ما يشاءون عند ربهم. They will get whatever they hope and they whatever they wish and whatever they want, they will receive in Jannah. والله أكبر. لهم ما يشاءون عند ربهم. ذلك جزاء المحسنين. This is the reward of المحسنين. ليكفر الله عنهم أسوأ الذي عملوا. And Allah will wipe and forgive all the bad sin and evil sin, the one they fall in. ليكفر الله عنهم أسوأ الذي عملوا ويجزيهم and reward them بأحسن ما كانوا يعملون. And Allah will reward them better than what they are, what they used to do. والله والله والله, I swear by Allah, the reward of the truth, the reward of الصدق, it's multiply in amazing reward. In any ibadah, if there is no honesty, there is no truth, no truthness in it, wallahi the ibadah is very weak. When it has a sidq, when it has a truth, when it has a honest in it, Allahu Akbar, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give rivers of reward. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give ocean of rewards to the person who has the truthlessness. And see this hadith. See this amazing hadith. And we used to memorize the hadith when we were as a children. And subhanAllah, now I come back to it. How important this hadith. And I wish all the Muslims teach their children this hadith. قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم عليكم بالصدق. Stick to the truth. Stick to be a صادق. فإن الصدق يهدي إلى البر. الصدق will guide you to all goodness. وَإِنَّ الْبِرَّ يَهْدِي إِلَى الْجَنَّةِ. And the goodness guide you to Jannah, to Al-Jannah, to Paradise, to Heaven, to Shurga. فَإِنَّ الصِّدْقَ يَهْدِي إِلَى الْبِرَّ وَإِنَّ الْبِرَّ يَهْدِي إِلَى الْجَنَّةِ وَلَا يَزَالُ الرَّجُلُ يَصْدُقُ وَيَتَحَرَّ الصِّدْقَ حَتَّى يُكْتَبَ عَنْدَ اللَّهِ صِدِّيقًا. And the person, he will say the truth and he become honest and truthful, honest and truthful, and honest and truthful, and is he care so much to be a truthful until Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, his name will be written Siddiqa, until his name will be written as a Siddiqa, like Abu Bakr Siddiq. He never have a doubt in whatever revelation came to Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He never have a doubtful in whatever Rasulullah said to him. So that make him higher level as-siddiq. He become as-siddiq. Abu Bakr as-siddiq. As-sadiq. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Wa iyyakum wal-kadhib. And be careful from lie. Say untruth. Lie. Be careful from lying. فَإِنَّ الْكَذِبَ يَهْدِي إِلَى الْفُجُورِ. The lie will guide you to the al-fujur, to the evil act, evil action, evil deeds. وَإِنَّ الْفُجُورَ يَهْدِي إِلَى النَّارِ. And the evil act will guide you to what? To hellfire, وَالْعِيَاذُ بِاللَّهِ. وَلَا يَزَالُ الرَّجُلُ يَكْذِبُ وَيَتْحَرَّ الْكَذِبُ. And the person, he lie and concentrate and focus and thinking how to lie, and he keep lying until he become, his name will be written a liar, كذابة, a liar, كذابة, a liar, كذابة. أعوذ بالله من الكذب. May Allah save us from all kind of lying. آمين يا رب العالمين. So this is a hadith, the important of الصدق.
عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال إن الصدق يهدي إلى البر وإن البر يهدي إلى الجنة وإن الرجل لا يصدق حتى يكتب عند الله صديقا.
مما لا شك فيه أن أعظم زينة يتزين بها المرء في حياته بعد الإيمان هي زينة الصدق. فالصدق هو أساس الإيمان، كما أن الكذب أساس النفاق، فلا يجتمع كذب وإيمان إلا وحدهما يحارب الآخر. فتعريف الصدق هو مطابقة القول للواقع، وهو أشرف الفضائل النفسية والمزايا الخلقية والخصائص.
شيخ talking about the one of the most important, the most important, subhanAllah, one of the character of Siddiq, because you need it all in your entire life. And the Siddiq, to say the reality, what does the Siddiq mean? To say the reality, your word matching the real, is not your word opposite about what is happening, what is going on. This is we call al-kadhib. And the Siddiq and lie together cannot be fit in the heart of the true believer. Cannot be, he is a liar and he is truthful. Cannot, he other than he will become a liar, wal'adhu billah, hypocrite, munafiq, lying day and night, or he become wal'adhu billah, truthful and sadiq. Very, very important to care about this. And now I remember one of the shurut, la ilaha illallah, subhanAllah, comes to my mind now. One of the condition of la ilaha illallah, every Muslim say la ilaha illallah Muhammadun Rasulullah. Ulama, they written 7 condition. The first one of la ilaha illallah, to in order to get it 100% to Allah will accept it from you, qal as-sidq. العلم واليقين والقبول والانقياد فدري ما أقول والصدق والإخلاص والمحبة وفقك الله لما أحب. 7 attributes, 7 صفات لا إله إلا الله. قال العلم, to understand, to have the knowledge about لا إله إلا الله, فاعلم أنه لا إله إلا الله. No, if I say لا إله إلا الله and I don't understand, what is that? So this is, I did not fulfill the condition of لا إله إلا الله. العلم واليقين and 100% belief, no doubt. والعلم واليقين والقبول and acceptance. والانقياد and you stead and follow the word of لا إله الله. والصدق, to be truthful to it. To be truthful in your belief. To be صادق with this statement inside your heart, in your tongue and in your action. So this is what one of the condition of لا إله إلا الله.
الجليل آثاره الهامة في حياة الفرد والمجتمع. الصدق في حياة رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم.
Analyze the صدق, the truth in the life of الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم.
رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم مثالا للقدوة في صفة الصدق. فقبل بعثته لقب من قبل قريش بالصادق الأمين. فقد كانوا يستودعون رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم حوائجهم ويأتمنونه على أشيائهم وأسرارهم. هذا وتنوع صدق إلى ثلاثة.
الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم, what his nickname before the Islam, before he come with the message of Islam, what is his nickname? As-Sadiq al-Amin. As-Sadiq al-Amin. They used to give all his the people in Mecca, they used to trust the Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam so much, even they used to put their money and their goods in the house of Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam with him, because he is trusted. He is trusted, and his nickname As-Sadiq al-Amin, the truthful one, the honest one. صلى الله عليه وسلم. طيب, أنواع الصدق. What is the category of the truth?
تأتي أنواع الصدق مع الله. فالصدق مع الله هو أجل أنواع الصدق, ويكون المسلم صادقا مع ربه تعالى إذا حقق الصدق في جوانب الثلاث: الإيمان والطاعة والأخلاق. الصدق مع النفس.
So الصدق مع الله. The ulama divided the truth, الصدق, to 3 parts. First part, to be truthful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. الصدق مع الله, والصدق مع النفس, والصدق مع الناس. الصدق مع الله, to believe in him and obey him and fulfill whatever commanded you. This is to be a truthful with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And I would like to share with you about the صدق of Allah before we continue this one, this clip about very amazing, talking about the صدق مع الله.
منزلة من أجل المنازل, ومن أوتي حظا كاملا موفورا فيها فهو بعد الأنبياء في المقام. قال الله عز وجل: ومن يطع الله والرسول فأولئك مع الذين أنعم الله عليهم من النبيين والصديقين والشهداء والصالحين وحسن أولئك رفيقا. فهي أعلى المنازل بعد منزلة النبوة. الله عز وجل قال في تأديبه لعباده المؤمنين: يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وكونوا مع الصادقين. وقال عز وجل: قال الله هذا يوم ينفع الصادقين صدقهم. فالصدق مع الله عز وجل منزلة جليلة كبيرة تعتمد على أمور ثلاثة: الصدق مع الله في النية، والصدق مع الله في القول، والصدق مع الله عز وجل في العمل. فأما صدق النية فعليها معول، فعليها فيكون الصدق في القول والعمل تبعا لها. وصدق مع الله في النية أن يعلم الإنسان أن الدنيا يحوزها من سبق، أما ما عند الله فإنما يحوزه من صدق.
Okay, Sheikh, talking about the صدق مع الله, it's one of the highest level after the messengers and prophet, as we mentioned. So if you want to get the highest level after the prophecy, no more prophet. الصدق, الصديقين. So الصدق مع الله is one of the highest level and very, very important for the believer to have it. So also he mentioned about three types of الصدق.
قال الله هذا يوم ينفع الصادقين صدق. فالصدق مع الله عز وجل منزلة جليلة كبيرة تعتمد على أمور ثلاثة: الصدق مع الله في النية.
So three things is important in order to get to be a truthful and honest to Allah. قال الصدق في النية. To be honest and truthful in your niyyah, that sincerity should be only to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
الصدق مع الله في القول والصدق مع الله عز وجل في العمل.
الصدق مع الله في القول والصدق مع الله في العمل. So niyyah start, and also to be a truthful when you say in your saying, and to be honest and truthful in your amal, in your action. So these three things is linked and attached to the title of الصدق مع الله.
فأما صدق النية فعليها معول، فعليها فيكون الصدق في القول والعمل تبعا لها. وصدق مع الله في النية أن يعلم الإنسان أن الدنيا يحوزها من سبق، أما ما عند الله فإنما يحوزه من صدق.
The صدق, the honest, okay, the honesty to with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the niyyah mean sincerity, okay, belief to be honest to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This very important, because the saying and action is follow the niyyah. The saying and action follow your sincerity and your niyyah. And subhanallah, he said in this dunya anybody can get it. Okay, but akhirah only to the honest one, to the truthful one. Say the dunya yahrizuha man sabaq, the one he's already passed, they can get the dunya, the past people or this time or whatever. But the one he on the akhirah, man sadaq, laysa sabaq, man sadaq. As-sadaq mean truth. Who has the truth? Who was the honest? He will earn the akhirat. Subhanallah.
وقد قلنا إن الله عز وجل يقول: يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وكونوا مع الصادقين. وكل يدعي في الغالب أنه صادق مع الله، لكن الله وحده من يعلم السرائر ويطلع عليها.
Everybody can claim I am the truthful towards Allah, but nobody knows except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, only Allah know what is in our heart.
وحسب المؤمن أن يكون له سريرة عند ربه جل وعلا يتوكل عليها إذا عثر، فإن العمل الصالح يقيم صاحبه إذا عثر. الصدق مع الله أن يعلم الإنسان أن هذه الدنيا جعلها الله جل وعلا طريقا إلى الآخرة، ويعلم أن أمور كلها بيد الله تبارك اسمه وجل ثناؤه.
One of the صدق مع الله, that a person he understand that the dunya only temporary, and what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prepared for the believer is better. So we should do for akhirah. This is one of the part of the truth, to be true, honest and truthful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
أمالنا أن لا نتوكل على الله وقد هدانا سبلنا، فنحن نحتاج إلى من يهدينا، ولا أحد يهدي إلا الله، فإن هدينا نحتاج إلى من يعيننا على تلك الهداية التي
We need the guidance. The only guidance can be get from Allah. If Allah give us guidance, we need somebody to help us. And you need help. So nobody can help us to steadfast except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So all the time, you are in need to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and you should be honest to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in order to that Allah help you to steadfast and remain in the right way.
أمنا أن لا نتوكل على الله وقد هدانا سبلنا كما أخبر الله عز وجل عن أنبيائه أنهم قالوا ذلك كما في سورة الخليل إبراهيم. والمراد أن الحديث عن الله صدق مع أن الصدق مع الله يطول الحديث عنه ويصعب الإنسان أن يتكلم فيه خوفا على نفسه. لكنك أيها الأخ المبارك الساعي أولا ومن يسمعني ويراني ثانيا، يجب أن تعلم أن الله عز وجل أجل من أن يخدع. الله يقول في حق المنافقين يخادعون الله وهو خادعهم.
الله أكبر. What a touching statement Sheikh said. Because it was a question on the TV. A person has asked how to be a truthful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He said, finally, you have to understand Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala level. How come you can cheat Allah? How day your mind can reach a level to think you are smart enough to cheat Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which He know you and know whatever you think and know what is inside your heart. أجل أن يخدع سبحان الله. يعني very very important that understanding. It will be live in our mind that Allah سبحان. How come I'm changing Allah سبحان تعالى؟ الله أكبر. What an amazing understanding.
ومن علم الله في قلبه خيرا سيأتيه الله عز وجل من الخير أكثر مما يؤمن. ولا بضاعة يضمرها المؤمن يلقى بها الله أعظم من الصدق معه تبارك اسمه وجل ثناؤه.
And he said there's no better deeds that you can face Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that you was honest and truthful towards Him. One of the best ibadah that you are really truthful and honest towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You never have a doubtful or lie or cheating or mucking around towards your creator. Subhanallah. This is one of really, really amazing character. Okay. Now, let's analyze some of the verses of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talking about the virtue of as-sidqu, as-sadiq, or sidq, truthful. قال تعالى في سورة يجزي الله الصادقين بصدقهم in the سورة الأحزاب. سورة الأحزاب آية number 24. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. ليجزي الله الصادقين بصدقهم ويعذب المنافقين إن شاء أو يتوب عليهم وكان الله غفورا رحيما.
That Allah may reward the truthful for their truth and punish the hypocrites if He wills or accept their repentance. Indeed, Allah is ever forgiving and merciful.
Allahu Akbar. This is one of the verse talking about ليجزي الله الصادقين بصدقهم. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reward the truthful because their truth, because of their truth. The second verses I would like to share also with you. قوله تعالى قوله تعالى سورة يونس آية نمبر 2. سورة يونس آية نمبر 2 قال تعالى بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم أكان للناس عجبا أن أوحينا إلى رجل منهم أن أنذر الناس وبشر الذين آمنوا أن لهم قدم صدق عند ربهم قال الكافرون إن هذا لساحر مبين. سبحان الله. The truthful one, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give him an honor. قدم صدق. قدم صدق عند ربهم. قدم صدق عند ربهم. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَبَشِّرِ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. Glad tidings, a good news for the believer, the one they have a صدق, The one they have صدق قدم صدق قدم صدق One of the virtue of the
Have people been amazed that we revealed revelation to a man from among them, saying, warn mankind and give good tidings to those who believe that they will have a firm precedence of honor with their Lord? But the disbelievers say, indeed, this is an obvious magician.
So this is the first virtue we talk about. Allah will give them قدم صدق عند ربهم. Glad tidings for them. Point number two, the truthful one, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will prepare for them a seat. Seat very close to their Lord. Okay, قال تعالى في سورة القمر سورة القمر بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إن المتقين في جنات ونهر في مقعد صدق عند مليك مقتدر الله أكبر
In a seat of honor near a sovereign perfect in ability
الله أكبر الله سبحانه وتعالى will prepare for them very high level honored for the الصادقين So this is the second also a verse from Surah it's a last verse from Surah Al-Qamar talking about the virtue of the people they used to have honesty and صدق Point number three Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made them Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made them with the best as we mentioned the ayah in the beginning best level قال تعالى في سورة النساء آية number 69 بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم ومن يطع الله والرسول فأولئك مع الذين أنعم الله عليهم من النبيين والصديقين والشهداء والصالحين وحسن أولئك رفيقا ومن يطع الله والرسول and whomever obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the messenger of Allah فأولئك مع الذين أنعم الله عليهم Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will put them with those Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless them and they get very high level النبيين the prophets and messengers والصديقين the honest and the truthful one والشهداء والصالحين now it's a question come to the mind what is this question why the people when the people of Al-Jannah the people of Al-Jannah why during the dunya time now we are in the dunya why in the dunya time they used to have a sidq let's find out first point is really important قال تعالى because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered them to be honest and truthful and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered them to be with honest and truthful one قال تعالى in Surah At-Tawbah ayah number 119 ayah number 119 بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وكونوا مع الصادقين.
O you who have believed, fear Allah and be with those who are true.
Allahu Akbar. So, be with who say the truth or who is honest. وكونوا مع الصادقين. Be with, stick to them, be among them, be part of them. Subhanallah, it's very important to be a truthful and to be with the truthful. And this is the order, it's a command from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The people of Jannah, they understood Allah commanded them, yes, Ya Allah, we obey, sami'na wa ata'na. We listen and we obey. We from now on, we inshallah, we will be among of the truthful and honest one. And also we want to be stick and hold on with the with the truthful people and with the honest people. Subhanallah. Because if you sit with the liar and learn the lying and you deal and do trading with the liar, you will get some of this attribute. You will be absorbed out of it. Subhanallah. And you will be disobeying Allah, that Allah ordered you to be with the truthful. So nowadays, if you analyze our time, how much lying exists? How much cheating exists? How much, subhanAllah, hypocrisy exists? Because the Muslim, the believer, they lack of understanding as-sidq. If they understood how important the sidq and how evil the deeds of the bad deeds of the lie, nobody like it. But analyze from morning until night how much people cheat, how much we are not really honest to ourselves and honest to Allah or honest to people. It's wal'iyadhu billah, I can see it. Especially the people, the when they involve in business. Ya Allah, Hasbunallah wa ni'mal wakeel. Wallahi, I wish I found a product outside. It's really honest or true. The people selling the true product. All fake, lie, put different name. And you see how much corrupted and cheating outside. And where? It's in the Muslim country. And this is, subhanAllah, showing it's a bad sign. Bad sign. If a'udhu billah, cheating exists everywhere. And the worst of that, I had been mixed with the people, wal'a'udhu billah, may Allah save us, mixed with them. You know what they say? If they cheat you, they will not consider cheating. They will consider, I am smart. I am intelligent. Oh my God, I can get the money from those people. And he's so happy and he tell his cheating story and lying story to his friend as a proud with it. Proudness, wallahi, I hear. He's a proud, yes. I make him, you know, I bag him. I cheated them and I get the money from them. And you know, I make them spin around. Astaghfirullah wa ta'ala. You are proud on you lying. You are proud in you kadhib and lie and cheat. Astaghfirullah wa ta'ala. Subhanallah. Now the understanding of honesty change from the mind of the true believer. We have to bring back this character back, inshallah, by the advice and by the training and by understanding this. Point number two. Because the people of Jannah, they understood that the way of Jannah, the way of truth and the way of honest. And the way of lie, were going to lead you to the angriness of Allah and to the hellfire. And the hadith is clear, we already mentioned in the beginning of the lecture. إِنَّ الصِّدْقَ يَهْدِي إِلَى الْبِرِّ وَالْكَذِبْ يَهْدِي إِلَى الْفُجُورِ. It's very clear hadith, very clear hadith. Also, قال الله تعالى in سورة الزمر, the one it's, we hear it, the ayah, قال تعالى فَمَنْ أَظْلَمُ مِمَّنْ كَذَبَ عَلَى اللَّهِ. Who is more wrongdoer? مَنْ أَظْلَمْ. Who is the worst of the worst? The one, he lie on Allah and lie on the truth and he reject the truth after he receive it. That's why I tell you, he said, you see, mashallah, some kuffar, they have a good akhlaq, they are honest with the people, they are honest, they never cheat in their business, they are very good behavior. But why Allah going to punish them, wal'adhu billah, forever in Jahannam? Because they are good and honest to the people, but they never was honest and truthful to Allah, to their creator. They never want to be honest, they want to believe the false, and they understood that is a false, it doesn't make sense at all. But they still deny it. That is the major things, major evil act. So here, very important. Man avlam, who is more worse or more wrongdoers than the one they, wal'adhu billah, lie, speak, subhanallah, he lie and he wasn't honest to Allah and he was lying and rejecting the truth. So it's very, very important to understand the truthful is very, very important. But the believer, they were honest to Allah. They believe in Allah. They accept Him, their God. They worship Him alone. They seek the help from Him, from Allah. They rely on Allah. They have tawakkul to Allah. They understood very well. The only can benefit you is your God, Allah. And the only can harm you is Allah. Tawheed, oneness of Allah is full of truthness, full of honesty. That's why with this tawheed, inshallah, Jannah will be guaranteed for you. Even if you have short or small sin. Subhanallah, that is a good tiding, glad tiding, good news for the sadiqeen. Point number three. لأن بالصدق يتحصل الإنسان على الخير الدنيا والآخرة. Because with the honesty and truthlessness, okay, saying the truth, you will achieve the goodness. قال تعالى فلو صدقوا الله لكان خيرا لهم. If they were truthful towards Allah, that is better for them. That is better for them. Subhanallah. So it's a reminder for us. Lie, it's spread around. We have to be aware from it. Even in our joke, we lie a lot. From now on, try to hold your tongue to say always the truth, even if you want to joke. Even if you want to say a story to make people laugh, don't say fake stories. Don't lie even. Try to be away from lying. We might fall in that wrong. So straight away ask forgiveness and try to analyze your tongue to be truthful whatever happened. SubhanAllah, that is the mean truthful. The truthful people, they will be happy in the dunya. What will happen to them in dunya? قال الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم الصدق طمأنينة والكذب ريبة. حديث رواية الإمام الترمذي صحيح الترمذي. قال الصدق طمأنينة والكذب ريبة. What is mean طمأنينة? طمأنينة mean relaxation. Always the honest one, the truthful one, he always happy and relaxed. ما في مشكلة, no problem, he's relaxed. But the liar, he is always in doubtful. The liar, he always in doubt, always in doubtful. He has a doubt about his own dignity. He has a doubtful about his own faith. He has a doubtful about everything around him. He think everybody liar. Because he has a problems, he's lie, so he will fall in the most of the sickness. And I wish I show you some really research done by non-Muslim that how is lie will affect your health. Wallahi, affect your health and affect your mind and make you stress and worries and subhanAllah, from there until you reach diseases and sickness, where the truthful man, he is relaxed. I'm not scared, I said the truth. What happened, what going to happen, let it happen. SubhanAllah, that's the difference between the true believer and the wal'adhu billah, the one, the kuffar or the zalimeen or the liar, how their life. Also, when the person is honest and truthful, when he sell and buy, or when he, subhanAllah, when he do trading, wallahi Allah will put barakah in his rizq, put barakah in his earning. But the liar, today he make money, next day he's scared. People disbelieve on him. You know, he already sell the product, he make profit. When he get a product again, nobody want to buy. They knew he's a liar. SubhanAllah. So the only he will buy from him, liar like him. So he can lie again. SubhanAllah. So this is the unhonesty or untruthfulness in even in trading or dealing with the people. SubhanAllah, it's make you lost. It's a way of lost. And I think most of you deal in the business, you know better. Stories about the people lost everything because of their cheating, because of their lying, SubhanAllah. Sometimes you make so much profit with a lie and cheat, but you spend so much money, huh? The money comes, the money goes very fast. Where's the barakah? No barakah. One of your children become sick, you spend all your money for the hospitals. SubhanAllah. So don't think about how much amount. Think how much barakah in it. So always the truthful will teach us that how to success in your life and also in business and earn money. And also the honest tajir, trading, who is doing trading, the honest one, he will be with the level of as-siddiqeen. He will be high level in Jannah because his honesty. Also as-siddiq fi talab al-shahada, the one he's honest and truthful to be a martyr, to be a shaheed. Because of his honesty and truthlessness, Rasul صلى الله عليه وسلم said, من سأل الله الشهادة بصدق, whomever asked Allah to give him, to make him among of the martyr, among of the shuhada, Allah will give him the level of shahada even if he die normally. Why? Because of صدق. He was a truth when he, truthful when he make dua to Allah. اللهم إني أسألك الشهادة, اللهم إني أسألك الشهادة, اللهم إني أسألك الشهادة. He asked Allah truth with the truth and honesty. So Allah will give him the level of الشهداء. Can you imagine how much الصدق is important? الصدق is not only, I mean, something difficult. It's very easy. Anybody can do it. And the reward for it is unlimited. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make them amount of the sadiqeen. What will happen to them in akhirat, in the next life? The truth will benefit the person in the next life. قال تعالى in surah, قال تعالى هذا يوم ينفع الصادقين صدقهم. هذا يوم ينفع الصادقين. This day ينفع الصادقين. The truthful one get benefit from their truthlessness, from their honest, they were honest. So today honesty will benefit them. Today their truth, when they used to speak truth, will benefit them. Allahu Akbar. It's one of the verse of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned. Also Allah says in Surah Al-Ma'idah ayah 119, قال تعالى هذا يوم ينفع الصادقين صدقهم لهم جنات تجري من تحت الأنهار. They used to, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prepared for them gardens, which is the river float underneath. خالدين فيها أبدا, forever in it. رضي الله عنهم ورضوا عن, and Allah pleased with them and they are pleased from Allah. ذلك الفوز العظيم. That is the great winning, great success. Allah says in Surah Al-Ma'idah, هذا يوم ينفع الصادقين صدقهم. That day, the honest will benefit, تنفع صاحبها, will benefit the owner of that, the owner of truth, the honest one. Brother and sister in Islam, if you would like to benefit yourself from the truth and sidq, what do you have to do? First of all, wherever happen, wherever you are, wherever you go, be truthful. Be sadiq. Make your tongue always truth come out from it. Subhanallah. Analyze yourself. Analyze your tongue. Analyze your action. Analyze your heart. Start again. Analyze your tongue. Analyze your heart. Analyze your action. And focus and think and care. Every single act from your life you do it, you move forward with the truth and honest. Here, inshallah, the changing will be. As the Rasul said, وَمَا يَزَالُ الرَّجُلُ يَصْدُقُ وَيَتْحَرَّ الصَّدِقُ. The person will be say the truth and honest. He is honest. وَيَتْحَرَّ الصَّدِقُ. And he care and analyze and focus and think and care all the time, not one time, to be a truthful. Until his name will be written صديقا. And صديقة is one صفة مبالغة للصدق. يعني one of the character, if the person do so much this character, he will be صديقة. Okay, he is will be صديقة. Not one time. I was honest last time. Like, what about today? I was truthful yesterday. How about tomorrow? So the person should be always with the truth, always with the honesty until will be written among of the people of the truthful one. Point number two, be friend with the truthful one, with the honest one. As Allah says, وَكُونُوا مَعَ الصَّادِقِينَ. Be with the truthful. Be with the honest one. Point number three, try to do as much you can from the good deeds. And be, when you do the good deeds, be sincere and truthful internally and externally. Internally and externally. Whatever you did, even your salah, even two rak'ah, you pray to Allah, be honest and truthful. That is for you, Allah. Not for anyone else. Not because my family watching me. Not because anyone is watching me. Subhanallah, this is how you train yourself to be honest and truthful one. Sister in Islam, wear your hijab, not because of the culture. You do it. Or I'm wearing hijab because I'm scared my friend will talk about me. Why you are not wearing hijab? Wear your hijab because you want to be honest to Allah. You want to be truthful to Allah. You wear it because Allah commanded me to do so. This is one of the example. I'm just trying to say some of example how to change our ibadah to be honest and truthful to Allah internally and externally. Insha'Allah, you will achieve the sidq. One of the very important of ibadah, as-sidq ma'a Allah, that tawheed, you fulfill it 100%. All your ibadah, analyze it and watch it and analyze it in details that must be sincere and for Allah. And this is the title and the main title of As-Sidq Ma'a Allah. And when you do this, inshallah, the tawheed, the oneness of Allah, tawheed al-ibadah, which is the most important part of tawheed, because tawheed al-ibadah, tawheed al-uluhiyya. Because tawheed is three category: tawheed al-rububiyya, wal-uluhiyya, wal-asma' wal-sifat. Al-uluhiyya, all the messengers and prophet, they came for tawheed al-uluhiyya. Because tawheed al-rububiyya, all the people believe in it. They believe Allah is a creator. They believe Allah is a sustainer. They believe in Allah is a ruler. But when you come to the ibadah, they associate someone with him. They perform some of the ibadah, not alone to Allah. They need to go to Allah through something. Through idols, through graveyard, through Mawlana, through Shaykh, through Ahlul Bayt, or through Jesus, or through Moses. All this is shirk and unacceptable by Allah. We want direct to Allah straight away. We don't need any one, any middle person. And this is really important to be truthful to Allah. So this is really important. Also to be truthful towards the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You want to be truthful with the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. First of all, love Rasul sallallahu Muhammad truly sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And obey him and follow the command of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Lift up and revive up his sunnah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. If I love Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I should love his sunnah, love his way of life. Not say I love Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, but I am enemy against of the people love the sunnah of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Or I hate the sunnah of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Or I think the sunnah of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is not suitable to the our modern time. As wal'adhu billah, foolish statement comes from the people. You know, they say the sunnah of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, it does not fit or suitable to the 2014. So which sunnah will be suitable? sunnah of the actors or dancer or the ladies in the club. This is a sunnah will be suitable to 2014. This is very evil. وَالْعِيَاذُ بِاللَّهِ understanding and propaganda through the media. They want to wash up the mind of the new generation. This is not right. Islam is beautiful for all the time and for all the age. Also, you have to be a truthful towards the Sahaba radiallahu anhum. Love the Sahaba. Love their way of life. Read their stories. Follow their way of life. And give them respect and honor. قال الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم عليكم بسنتي وسنة الخلفاء الراشدين المهديين من بعد عضوا عليها بالنواجد. قال الله سبحانه عليكم بسنتي hold my sunnah, my way of life, hold to it, and the way of the خلفاء الراشدين من بعد, the sunnah of the follower from خلفاء أبو بكر وعمر وعثمان وعلي and صحابة, referring to صحابة after me, عضوا عليها, bite it and hold in it, even in your forward teeth, النواجد. This is the four teeth. Even if you can bite it, hold it, stick to it. Don't hesitate to follow it. So this is the advice of Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam in the time of fitna. As we are in the time of fitna, we should be more honest and truthful to Allah. In the time of fitna, we should be more truthful and honest to the people, because it's a bad news. Before the day of judgment, Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam قال تقبط الأمانة من صدور الرجال. The amana, the trust, will be taken and removing away from the heart of the men. Just small mark will be left over. Then the amana will be taken away again until what is left is like a dot. And the people will say, in this place or in this village, a person is honest. Allahu Akbar. يعني the honest people or truthful one, you can account it. How many one? Showing والعياذ بالله, the amana will be lost. The trust will be lost. The honesty will be lost. And this is one of the majors, one of the minor sign of the day of judgment. والعياذ بالله. The corruption will spread around. May Allah save us and protect us. Also, about the mark and the honesty. In the hadith of Rasul Sallam, قال يأتي زمان, the time will come, يصدق فيها الكاذب, the liar, people will believe in him, ويكذب فيها الصادق, and the truthful, the people will say about him, he is the liar, ويؤتمن فيه الخائن, and the people will trust the cheater. ويخون فيها الأمين, and the one he is trusted, the people will see he is cheating. Allahu Akbar. And you see now, analyze it in our real life. Yesterday I received very touching a person. He's one of the ulama from Bangladesh. They want to execute him. And when, you know, last day, subhanAllah, going to take him to execute, he's a scholar of Islam. The family met him, and they said to the family, when he farewelled them, he said, I didn't do anything wrong. They're going to execute me. You know why? Because I am a Muslim. SubhanAllah. Shuf. They execute the truthful and the good and the scholars of Islam, the one they teach the goodness and honest. And wal'a'udhu billah, corrupted and stealing the money and cheating and running the business behind, hidden business and lie and wal'a'udhu billah, doing the evil act, they will be, you know, honored. Oh no, maybe they interview them in the TV. They are the best example for the country. And this is, you see the fitna, how hard and how big is it? It is. If you analyze, Look at wal'adh billah and the Muslims around the countries. The truthful one, the one they want to free themselves, defend their country, save their country, establish the peace. They will call them, what? Terrorist. Terrorist. Wal'adh billah. Evil people. And the one, they are the killer, a liar, and cheater, and sucking all the goodness from this country. What they call them? The good, the high class people. And this is, wal'adhu billah, the fitna in our time. So we have to be careful and wake up and stick to the honest. Wallahi will not save us, subhanallah, better than the character and attribute of honesty and sidq. If all the Muslims truthful and honest and one heart, wallahi you will not see the situation we are now. But this is, subhanallah, character being banding for a certain time. We should come back to it. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us this character to be honest. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us وَيَجْعَلَنَا مِنَ الصَّادِقِينَ. اللَّهُمَّ اجْعَلْنَا مِنَ الصَّادِقِينَ. اللَّهُمَّ اجْعَلْنَا مِنَ الصَّادِقِينَ. اللَّهُمَّ اجْعَلْنَا مِنَ الصَّادِقِينَ. اللَّهُمَّ اجْعَلْنَا مِنَ الصَّادِقِينَ مَعَكَ وَالصَّادِقِينَ مَعَ النَّاسِ وَالصَّادِقِينَ مَعَ أَنفُسِهِمْ وَاجْعَلْنَا مِنَ الصِّدِّيقِينَ. وَاحْشُرْنَا مَعَ الصِّدِّيقِينَ وَالْأَنْبِيَاءِ وَالصَّالِحِينَ وَالشُّهَدَاءِ وَاجْعَلْنَا مِنَ الصَّالِحِينَ يَا رَبَّ الْعَالَمِينَ وحسن أولئك رفيقا. اللهم ارزقنا الإخلاص في القول والعمل. اللهم إنا نعوذ بك أن نشرك بك ونحن نعلم ونستغفرك لما لا نعلم. اللهم إنا نعوذ بك من النفاق ومن سوء الأخلاق. اللهم اجعلنا من الذين يستمعون القول فيتبعون أحسن. آمين. وصلى الله وسلم محمد وعلى صحبه أجمعين. Any question إن شاء الله؟ Any question؟ No question. I remember, subhanAllah, a small story I did not mention, I forgot in the time. In the time of Rasulullah Sallam, there is three Sahaba. They did not go for the battle of Tabuk. When Nabi Sallam came back, all the hypocrite people, they came and lie. I didn't go with you, Rasulullah, because my family, because my mother, because. Everybody say a reason. And Nabi let them go. Okay, no problem. Subhanallah, all this hypocrite, they lie. Allah exposed their evil act in the Quran, in Surah At-Tawbah. And Allah become angry from them and exposed their bad, evil things. But this three Sahaba, because they were honest and they came and said, Ya Rasulullah, wallahi, we don't have any reason. We wrong ourselves. And the punishment was difficult. Painful, because Nabi Sallam not allow any one from Sahaba to communicate with them and sell or buy from the buy or sell them, and they remain almost 1 month banded and neglect even their wife, not talking to them. Can you imagine your own wife cannot talk to you? How painful is? And king of Romania, they send them letter, if your friend Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam abandoning you, come, I welcome you in my palace and my castle. And he straight away, he cut the letter and throw it. He said, I don't want even to entertain it in my mind. Look at the truthful. Not he think, I read it later, maybe I think about this option. No. Throw it. I am truthful. I am wrongdoing. I'm waiting for Allah to forgive me. And I really love Allah and Rasulullah. Then what is the end of the story? Allah revealed down ayat, verses from Surah Tawbah. Allah mentioned their names and Allah accept their repentance. وعلى الثلاثة three الذين خلفوا حتى إذا ضاقت عليهم الأرض بما رحبت وضاقت عليهم أنفسهم وظنوا أن لا ملجأ من الله إلا إليه. And they believe and understood there is no opening except to run towards your Lord. Then Allah ثم تاب عليهم ليتوبوا. Allah accept their repentance and Allah accept them. إنه بهم غفور رحيم. Allah forgive them. When the one Sahabi came to Ka'b, Hilal bin Umayyah wa Ka'b, when he came and told him the story that Allah accepted his tawbah, and he recited for him the verse, out of happiness he take off his thawb, his clothes, and he give him as a hadiyah. He said, wallahi, I don't have accept this. this for you hadiyah. And he ran to Rasul Sallam crying and hugging all the Sahaba that Allah accept his tawbah. And as he's the best day from all his entire life. What is make Allah accept his tawbah? Because of honesty. Allahu Akbar. Jazakum Allah khair. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.